Good morning everyone, I am recording with a different camera again in full 4K resolution. This camera is very kindly sent out to me by Park Cameras. I'll leave a link to their website down in the video description, and it is the Sony RX100 Mark V. Now in my previous video I was recording with the Panasonic LX10 or LX15 as it's known in some countries, and it's a great camera, very pin sharp focus, great amount of detail, quite a lot of crop when you're recording in 4K, and I was very keen to try out the Sony RX100 Mark V as well. It certainly looks absolutely superb, very crisp on the screen, and I want to just test the autofocus as well. I've currently got it to actually lock onto my face. I've got face recognition turned on, but I want to just pull this up closer to the lens and see if it does in fact pull that focus in, and it does. Just look at that detail. It's really nice and quick to focus as well. Coming back to my face, look, pin sharp focus again, so I'm really impressed with the actual focus speed and the quality of that tiny little screen, and it even switches between portrait and macro modes as I put this remote control closer to the lens, so very impressive. But anyway, I'm going to get on with the rest of my day and I'm going to shoot with the Sony RX100 Mark V today so you can see what it looks like in full 4K resolution. So I've just finished my recording session and I wanted to show you two items of the three that I ordered on Black Friday. I ordered these online. The two that have already been delivered are sitting just behind me here, and they were from Park Cameras. Fantastic deal on them. It was 25% off on the day. The third one I will share with you when it's actually delivered. They are both tripod related. The first one is this fluid head from Manfrotto. Here's the model number just underneath here. It's the MVH502AH, and it is absolutely superb. So smooth. Now I already had the Manfrotto 190 Go, the tripod legs, so it's purely just this head section that I purchased. And it is fantastic. I'm so pleased with it. It's also got this fluid drag system control on this side, and it's also got mounting points as well, so you can mount the handle on either side and you can mount accessories on this side or indeed on this side. Now the other one I purchased was a full tripod and head system. It's the Manfrotto B3 Live. Again, this was 25% off, and it came complete with a fluid head as well. It's not quite as smooth as the other one, but it still is very smooth, and this is just a much more compact tripod. So this one I would use in the studio, and then this one I would probably use on location if I wanted to travel a little bit lighter. So it's now early evening, and I must say I've looked back at some of the footage from this little camera here, the Sony RX100 Mark V, and it looks very good indeed. I'm really impressed. There's a lot less crop when you're recording in 4K on this camera when compared to the Panasonic LX10 or LX15. The colours are a little bit more muted, and overall the actual audio quality is about the same, I would say. Probably a little tiny bit better on the Sony. But let me know what you think in the comments section below. Now I also want to discuss with you a potential problem with the new 2016 MacBook Pros, the one with the touch bar. Not sure if it exists with the 13-inch version because I haven't got that, the one without the touch bar. But it certainly does exist on the two MacBook Pros I've got here. Now I've got the 13-inch version with touch bar, and also the 15-inch version with touch bar, and I've had three conversations with different people at Apple, plus two phone calls back as well. And I'll let you know what the problem is first, and I'll let you know their sort of take on it and their decision. The problem, when you're using the laptop as normal, absolutely fine, no issues at all.
when you use the laptop when it's charging, that is where the problem exists. So using the new USB-C power adapter with the little tiny sort of plug converter plugged onto it, when you're charging the laptop, if your hand brushes up against the area just above where you'd normally rest your wrist, so where the little speaker grills, the little tiny drilled holes for the speakers, where that starts, you get like a static electricity vibrating type sensation on your hand. And in fact, if you do it purposely, if you rub your finger across those speaker grills, then you get that sensation. Now, it's not an electric shock. It's not dangerous at all, or at least I don't think it is, but it's just like a vibrating static electricity type sensation. Now, this only happens when you're charging the laptop. When you're not charging it, it's absolutely fine. Now, I did a little bit of a test. I grabbed the 3-pin earthed extension cable that came with my Retina MacBook Pro and plugged that into the USB-C charging brick and then charged it and used the laptop. No issue at all. You don't get the static electricity or this vibrating sensation. It only happens when you're using just the little tiny power adapter plugged into the power brick, so i.e. when it's not earthed. I spoke to 3 different people at Apple and got 2 phone calls back. Their take on the subject is that it's perfectly normal. It's within safety limits for the device. It's not causing any harm. I asked them, in fact, I asked one of the senior techs there, would they make me happy? Would they make me a satisfied customer by sending out 2 of these extension cables? Because then the problem disappears. And they flatly refused. They said they would not do that. So I'm pushing for an answer at a more executive level now, and I'll update you in a future video as to what they say. But my question to you is, what do you think about it? Do you think I'm right in saying that it's easily solved by sending out these cables? Do you think I should have to buy the cables, or they should supply them free of charge? Or indeed, do you have that problem on your new 13-inch or 15-inch MacBook Pro with Touch Bar? Let me know down in the comments section below. Also, let me know what you think of the video and audio quality. I'll see you in another video very soon.